Pastor Justin Smoot. I am the interim. Is this working? Can you hear me? Is it going? No? Off and on. How is this? Better? Good? Thumbs up? All right. I'm the interim director of Camp Waypost over in Hatley, and I thank you for the invitation to come and to fellowship and to share the gospel on this Holy Trinity Sunday. It also looks, I think my pack got all kinds of tangled up when I put it back in the pocket. It looks like, Did I stick it down there and I felt like an anchor was pulling down on my ear. It's not a fun thing. So we have a few folks still signing in for the meeting that is going to be happening after the service that I'm sure you've all been hearing about and talking about for the past few weeks. A very exciting day. But this is also Holy Trinity Sunday, and we're at the end of the Easter season, the beginning of the season after Pentecost, and it's sort of a turning of the page where we have heard the story of our Lord Jesus and how he came into this world and taught and lived and died and rose that we might have life, and now we get to go live. There are, welcome to all of you who are joining online, that you have found us via the internet. Glad to see you here. Well, I'm glad that you see me here, because I can't see you because you're not here. But we are glad that you have found us, whether it is live Sunday morning or any other time during the week. Glad that you could have a time to pause and reflect on what God is doing. And there is the weekly word with some announcements in it. One that was kind of very nicely added to the bullet or to the worship folder here was talking about the preparations for the diaper closet. I see that there is the cookie jar out back for monetary donations, but it says the shelving is in place and some diapers have been purchased. And thank you to those of you who have volunteered to help stock and work the diaper closet. And I guess they're still looking for more, so keep on signing up for that. Try to find a way to work that into your routines in your weeks and months this summer. And the donations of diapers themselves or money to purchase diapers will be accepted at the church office anytime that it is open. And there's a very sincere thank you for everything that you have done to help bring this ministry, this needed addition to the community into being. And I know that because there's a meeting afterwards, I will not be going back to shake hands on the way out because I think you want to get started on that. So I'm just going to sneak out this way. But know that I'll be back in a couple of weeks. I think my next time here is in like 2 weeks that I'll be up to preach and to share and to fellowship with you all. How are we doing with the line back there? I still see a few. But we can continue our gathering this morning, as I know you've been gathering and talking and sharing with folks now. I invite you to stand as you're able to turn and face the font as we come to the confession and forgiveness of our sins. Blessed be the Holy Trinity. One God who greets us in this and every season, whose word never fails, and whose promise is sure. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Righteous God, we confess that we have sinned. We have failed to be honest. We have lacked courage to speak. We is a cup of cold water when we thirst. God offers boundless grace when we fail. Claim the gift of God's mercy. You are freed and forgiven in the name of Christ.
Amen.
Amen. Let us join in our gathering hymns. Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, as found printed in your bulletin.
Thank you.
Creator and ever-living God. We worship your glory, eternal three in one, and we praise your power, majestic one in three. Keep us steadfast in this faith, defend us in all adversity, and bring us at last into your presence, where you live in endless joy and love, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
You may be seated as we turn to our reading. I forgot to ask, is there a reader appointed for this day?
Our first reading comes from the book of Genesis, the first chapter. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky. And there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning, the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years, and let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. And God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, "Let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky." So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, "Be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters and the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." And there was evening and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, "Let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things, and wild animals of the earth of every kind." And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth." So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God he created them, male and female he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, "Be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth." God said, See, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps upon the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed it was very good. And there was evening and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and their multitude. And on the seventh day God finished the work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. I invite you to join me in reading Psalm 8 responsively by whole verse. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of infants and children. You have set up a fortress against your enemies to silence the foe and avenger.
When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and stars you have set in their courses.
What are mere mortals that you should be mindful of them? Human beings that you should care for them.
Yet you have made them a little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them. You have made them rule over the works of your hands.
You have put all things under their feet,
all flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Our second reading comes from the second letter to the Corinthians, beginning in the 13th chapter. Paul writes, "Finally, brothers and sisters, farewell. Put things in order, listen to my appeal, agree with one another, live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. I invite you to stand as you are able for the singing of the gospel acclamation. Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 28th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always, to the end of the age." This is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated, and I invite any children here to come forward for a children's message. Want to come on up?
I got something for you. What do I have here?
Bubbles.
Yeah. Do you like bubbles? You want to blow some? You take the wand out and blow it. Hey, that's a nice stream of bubbles. Can you catch them?
bubbles are kind of like the Holy Trinity. Now, how many of those words did you understand? Just bubbles? Yeah. So there is something. Did you want to blow some bubbles too? Alright. Well, I only have one wand, so you'll have to share. So take the wand and dip it in there. Oh, the hole there. Alright, blow. Hey, that was fun. Did you catch it? Too fast. Alright. So, the Trinity is one of the names that we have for God. And it talks about how we have God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. But there's not three different gods we worship, we just worship one God. And there's a lot of different ways to describe how that works, and all of them only get a little bit of a picture. But I like bubbles as an image, and I'll tell you why. So, what makes up a bubble? Bubble solution, which if you don't have a store to get it, you can make using soap and water, right? Yeah. So there's soap and water. But if you just had soap and water together, would you have bubbles? No, what do you need? We need a little wind to blow through it, right? But if you have it on the wand, there's just soapy water there until the bubbles are gone. And that's the soap, the water, and the air are all the bubble. They're unique, but they're all there to make the bubble. Just like God the Father who created us, God the Son, that's Jesus, and God the Holy Spirit that blows through our world are all God. You can't really separate them because it's one God, but they're all connected. And you know what? Oh, standing on the curtain. And you know what this God does? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. God lives connected to each other and to us the same way. We cannot have bubbles without all three things. Isn't that a neat little image? Does that help you understand a little bit more of the Holy Trinity? Yeah. And only just a little bit more, because at the end of the day, God is really big and hard to understand, but we can see a few things and learn about how to live in relationship by blowing bubbles. You want this? You can take it. Why don't we say a prayer? Can you fold your hands and repeat after me? Thank you, God, for creating us. Thank you, God, for coming into our world and saving us. Thank you, God, for showing us how to serve and giving us gifts to share. Help us live in relationship connected to you and your people, so that we may all blow bubbles and share your love, your joy, and your peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, thanks for coming up. Thanks for helping me share a little bit about the Trinity with bubbles. And you can have a lot of fun with that, blowing bubbles all day long. All right? Thanks for coming up. And I think you can share with her. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O God, our rock and our redeemer. And let the people of God say, Amen. We are at that celebration of the Holy Trinity, this divine mystery that I have heard described in so many different ways. I don't know if you have a favorite one. Is there a favorite image of the Trinity that you remember from your time in Sunday school or catechism, or that you have discovered any place?
Mary and Joseph.
Anybody hear about the Trinity as ice? It's water and the ice cube and the water vapor. Or what about one that I didn't hear about till later in life was the apple. Anyone heard of one? There's like the peel of the apple, the flesh of the apple, the seed of the apple. And what about anybody remember St. Patrick and the clover? That's a classic one where legend has it that St. Patrick taught about the Trinity to the people of Ireland using the clover, which is a common plant in that land. But each one of those, as I told the kids, only gets one little glimpse of the Holy Trinity, because there is a great mystery there of their unity and their personhood that we can't quite capture in any way. But we can take time on this Holy Trinity Sunday to reflect upon one aspect of the Trinity and see how to bring that out more completely in our communities. And the aspect here that we see kind of woven throughout our readings and in the image of the bubble is relationship. Because God is in relationship with God's own self. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit dwelling together, living together. We see that in the way that at that creation story, God says, let us make humankind in our own image. That the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit there at the moment of creation see this world and need to make humans in the image of this relational God. We see it too in the words of Jesus as he sends the disciples out into the world to baptize in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And yet, in some ways, the way we say it, it's not three names, but one name, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we see that Trinitarian formula continued by Paul in his farewell to the Corinthians, the closing of his letter there, that we also use at the opening of our service, where we invoke the name of the triune God. And this relationship of God with God's self is also extended in our creation. For we read that we are created in God's image, that there is an immediate relationship between God and us. Almost the same way that when we look in a mirror, we see an image of ourselves. It's not quite the same, and I don't know if you've been on any kind of Zoom calls and have not had your own, like, view mirror. You look really different, because we're so used to seeing ourselves in a mirror. But that is the way that God views us, as if we're looking in a mirror, which also means that when we look at one another, we see reflected in not just the face and the physical appearance, but in the body, in the spirit, in the mind and the heart of each and every person that we encounter, we see a reflection of God's own being. And this connection that God brings us into is even deeper than that. Because if you continue reading in Genesis 2, there is the story of God forming the first human being by the banks of a river. And the first human being is named Adam, which in Hebrew means humanity. And what that human being is formed from is the ground there by the river, Adamah, in Hebrew. We are Adam from Adamah. There's a similar little wordplay in English. We are humans from humus. That biological essence of the earth, that ecosystem that is there under our feet, that living substance of our world itself, we are part and parcel of creation and given a special place, given a connection to the earth that we have come from, to the animals that surround us and help us in our daily lives. Yes, even to the mosquitoes that suck my blood at camp. We are connected for their short little lives. But this connection makes us a part of it. That we cannot truly live apart from this land which we receive the bounty from to grace our tables at meals and share with others. That we go out of these doors and we see all around us in the world, in the parks, in the rivers, in the places we go. Heck, even every single element of this building came from nature in some way. The glass was at one time sand. The pews were at one time trees. The metal that fastens us all together was at one time buried deep in the earth. This connection to our world and creation, the connection of God in relationship with God's self, is built there into our world, our reality. And so too, the connection with God and us as we are washed in the waters of baptism. Water, an element that flows through this town, flows through this world, that we gather around to recreate and refresh. God is with us as we come to this table and receive wine and bread. What was once wheat of the field and water, what was grapes of the vine, gathered together with the fermentation process of that life on our earth. And we are fed by this relationship, and we are sent forth, just as Jesus sent the disciples forth with that promise that I will be with you always, even to the end of the age. Meaning, as we go forth not by ourselves, but always and ever in relationship with God. We go forth out of those doors to meet God in the faces of those whom we live next to, those whom we live alongside of, those whom we work with, those in our families. And we recognize that they are gifted as we are gifted. And together with our connections, our relationships, our gifts shared and pooled together, we can be that source of life, of joy, of resurrection hope for the world that we live in, for the world that we are so connected. And at this point, you're wondering, why? Why did God do this? Because in some ways, we feel small. We feel limited. We only know the people we know. We don't feel like we can make a big impact. So why would God choose us? Why would God draw close to us? And that, my siblings in Christ, is the wondrous mystery of the Trinity. God in relationship with us and for us. As the psalmist says, we have been made just a little bit lower than the angels. And yet, who are we that God is in relationship with? For we are the ones who are the beneficiaries of God's grace, the grace of the Holy Spirit that comes to us. We are the beloved of God, the love of God that reaches into our world in the form of Jesus to find us and unite us in this relationship once again. We are the ones in communion, the communion of the Holy Spirit that draws us and gathers us in, that washes us in these waters of baptism with the promise that no matter where we go in this world, we will not be farther from God than our very breath. So we can go out, and we can come in. We can live the lives of relationships that we have been woven into and connected to since the day of our birth. And we can share with all those who we meet this transforming love of God who draws close to us, not because of who we are, but because that is who God is. The one who brings relationships to life, and life to relationships. The one who draws us into this mystery of the Holy Trinity, this whirling dance that we find ourselves turned upside down and inside out in the best possible way, and then blown out into the world to just radiate that joy and that love and that peace to others. And so as we gather here and prepare to receive the body and blood of Christ, we gather here in communion with our God, in the mystery of the Holy Trinity. And we find ourselves renewed and shaped and sent in the best possible way to share that connection, to draw others into it, until we can get back to that place of creation But God looked back and said, it was very good. Amen.
I invite you to stand as you're able and join in our hymn of the day, God Whose Almighty Word.
Let us profess our faith in the triune God.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Trusting in God's abundant mercy, let us offer prayers for a world in need. I think I remember from last night there's a different response. What is the response in your bulletin?
Your mercy is great.
Okay. Holy Three, Holy One, you call the church to make disciples of all nations. Encourage bishops, pastors, and deacons in their proclamation of the gospel. And direct us, and direct all the baptized into lives of service, humble service. Hear us, O Lord.
Your mercy is great.
Holy Three, Holy One, you spoke creation into being and called it good. Protect lands and waters threatened by human misuse and sustain living creatures of every kind, wild animals, birds, fish, and every creeping thing. Hear us, O Lord.
Your mercy is great.
Holy Three, Holy One, you have given humankind authority over the earth. Raise up leaders who listen earnestly, speak honestly, and govern thoughtfully. Heal divisions between nations that we might agree with one another and live in peace. Hear us, O Lord.
Your mercy is great.
Holy One and Holy Three, you promise to be with us always to the end of the age. Surround those most in need of your healing presence, any who are lonely, all who are grieving, and those who are sick, especially those whose names are on our prayer list, those whose names are in our hearts, and those whose names are known only to you. Hear us, O Lord. Holy Three, Holy One, you set this earth on its axis, and we experience the seasons. Strengthen those enduring challenges this summer, those who suffer in the heat, parents overwhelmed by child care needs and responsibilities, and children experiencing food insecurity outside of the school. Hear us, O Lord. Holy Three and Holy One, you give rest when our work is done. We give thanks for all the saints who now rest in you, confident in the promise of resurrection life in the age to come. Hear us, O Lord. Receive our prayers and answer us, O Triune God, in the name of Jesus Christ, your word made flesh. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
I invite you to share a sign of God's peace with one another. And let us join in our offering hymn as the offering plates are brought forward. Sustain us with these gifts of creation and multiply your graciousness in us, that the world may be fed with your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God. You reveal your glory as the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, equal in majesty, undivided in splendor, one Lord, one God, ever to be adored in your eternal glory. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Thank you.
in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Gathered into relationship with the Holy Trinity around our Lord's table, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. You may be seated. All are welcome to receive Holy Communion this day. We have gluten-free wafers here, as well as grape juice, if that is your choice, in the lighter colored liquid in the tray. To those of you who are receiving communion at home, the body of Christ given for you, the blood of Christ shed. The table is now ready.
Thank you. invite you to stand as you're able.
Beloved of God, we are now at this very moment within the bounds of heaven in the presence of our triune God. And may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we have received here this day strengthen you and keep you in God's grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. We thank you, generous God, for the refreshment we have received at your banquet table. Send us now to spread your generosity into all the world through the one who is our dearest treasure, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Receive the benediction. The God who calls across the cosmos and speaks in the smallest seed, now bless, keep, and sustain you this day and unto the end of the age. Amen. Our ascending hymn this day is Rise, Shine, You People. Let us sing.